Present, my topic is about refractive surgery, options, possibilities, limits. We have important experience in this kind of field of ophthalmology, and this is why I want to show you. Patients' demand for surgical correction of refractive errors has dramatically increased over the years, resulting in a rapid development of instruments and techniques to best satisfy these demands. Mainly, there are two categories of refractive surgery technique available: corneal laser surgery and the lens refractive surgery. Our options. Everything I tell you now is about it on our attitude about for the patient. Refractive surgery options: corneal laser surgery, ERK, femtolasic, relax smile, press beyond. This is what we can do. We do lens surgery, cataract surgery, and refractive lens exchange, anterior and posterior chamber phakic AOLs, but this last technique we don't do. The refractive surgery candidate is an important point of this treatment. Profile of the refractive surgery candidate is young, active, and informed person who wishes to become spectacle independent with minimum discomfort and risks. Setting a correct patient's expectation is one of the key of the patient's satisfaction and cooperation. It's important to understand the needs of the satisfaction and the satisfaction level of our patients. This is time consuming. You have to discuss a lot with the patient to understand well what he wants, because otherwise he's not a final good result. PRK, treatment protocol, myopia till 5, astigmatism, myopic astigmatism till 2, hyperopia till 1.5, no hyperopic astigmatism treatment performed with PRK. Disadvantages: slower postoperative recovery and risk of regression result. Femtolasic, myopia till 7, myopic astigmatism till 5, hyperopia till 4 or more, a little bit, hyperopic astigmatism till 4, hyperopic spherical equipment till 4. Less risk of diopter regression, more comfortable for the patient, painless procedure with rapid visual recovery. But disadvantages: variable impairment of corneal biomechanics, risk of ectasia. Relax smile, all femto one laser procedure with VisuMax from size, myopia till 10, myopic astigmatism till 10, till 5, spheric equivalent till 50. Incidence of dry eye syndrome is reduced comparing with femtolasic. Flapless preserves the biomechanical stability. Patient friendly, well tolerated. Normally you can come back to the normal life in 72 hours. Disadvantages: expensive procedure, limited retreatment options, but there are. This is our technique. This is a suction time. Suction time. We are doing this technique from 2014. And in clinic, there are three doctors performing this wonderful technique. I want to be a little bit. Yes. other. And now we take out the reticule. And that's all. About this technique, RelaxMind, till from 2014 till present, over to 2,850 procedures. In Romania, there are only our clinic performing a big quantity of the treatment. Visually, acuity after 24 hours is very good. Spectacle contact lens independence has been achieved in all cases. Post-operative treatment regimen is simple and well tolerated, with steroids to 2 weeks and lubricants. Post-operative reactions are very low, blurred vision for a while, mild tearing of photophobia. No treatment so far in this many cases. PressBeyond. PressBeyond is a femtolasic procedure. He also corrects the spherical aberration and blends monovision in order to achieve glass independence. It's a very wonderful technique for the patient affected by presbyopia. The dominant eye is treated to plano, yes, and the non-dominant eye is treated to mild, mild myopia, minus 0.75 till minus 1.50. So this is an important moment for the patient to include or exclude the patient because of the testing this possibility to be in a kind of monovision. This is the principle of the treatment. Dominant eye in right side is treated for zero for plano, and the non-dominant eye is treated for minus 1.5, and there is a blend zone, as you see, where the patient can see better and is spectacle independent. About this technique, it's useful because in type, this patient is 48 years old. When he will develop cataract, 6 years old, he will remain spectacle independent also after cataract surgery. Will be the same situation, no more glasses. Intraocular refractive surgery. Mainly, we use monofocal wells, toric or not, multifocal, toric or not, extended depth of focus, also different, which provide clear vision at all distances with extended depth of focus. Accommodating IOLs we don't use. Phakic IOLs we don't use, but there are also. Pros and cons. It is a treatment of choice extreme diopters and can be only choice to mild to hyperopia and presbyopia, corneal pathology, or lens opacities. Each IOL has advantages and disadvantages in terms of best corrected visual acuity, intermediate, far distance, as well as the likelihood and degree of postoperative vision disturbances, halos, and night glare. Lens replacement surgery is more invasive than refractive surgery laser and comes with slightly more difficult significant risk. Therefore, we always prefer to corneal surgery first. However, sight-threatening complications are extremely rare, and the most complication can be successfully treated with medication or additional surgery, let's say eczema laser surgery. The main issue of the postoperative neuroadaptation, which can last up to 12 months, We inform all our patients about the issue and identify difficult cases like night driver. This is an important point. For night drivers, it's a special case, and we have to be very, very careful with this patient, because we can, if everything is not okay, the patient can have to give up to the profession. We have an extensive history of our clinic of multifocals successfully used for both cataract and refractive lenses change with satisfied patients. Intraocular refractive surgery, multifocal, we use are in our clinic. It was 20% in 2015, and now in 2019 was 35%. Mainly, we started with Atelisa from Zeiss, bifocal initially, and now trifocal, because it's very good. We have very good results. We are very satisfied about this Zeiss Atelisa. Now there is also Atelara, which is an extended depth of focus for depends of the case. Johnson & Johnson Synergy, good visual result overall, with few halos and improvement contrast. Sifi, Miniwell, Ready, and Proxa variant EDOF, very good overall distances, vision. No halos, glare, starburst, very good contrast sensitivity, different part as Atelisa, as I told you. Monofocals are preferred only when the patient is high myope with maculopathy. So in this case, we don't want to use multifocal, because the quantity of light in the eye is not enough. This is a number of IOLs we use, different producers, and we try all the time will be in the best. Preoperative evaluation before refractive surgery. Manifest encycloplegic refraction, distance and near corrected and visual acuity, slit lamp examination, intraocular. It's a very extensive examination from specular microscopy till visual field and OCT and everything we have to know. Important is Schirmer test. The patient is required to do some routine blood tests and conjunctival secretion exam. Complications. Complications can be more easily managed when working together with a patient as a team. Well, an informed patient having the correct expectation will be more compliant patient when something happened during the healing process. About laser surgery. About laser surgery, intraoperative, important are mainly flap related. Postoperative, keratitis, high IOP, it happened, erosion, invasion, epithelial invasion, which means many times intervention. Complication, the refractive lenses change, is a posterior capsule rupture, vitreous loss, that time we don't use a multifocal, and others. Decision making, that's a very complicated process, depends on the experience of the doctor. The spectacular development of refractive surgical technique, instrument, postoperative treatment regimen during the past decade has created a vast range of options and for both patients and physicians, all refractive surgeons must consider the lifestyle expectations and fears of every one of their patients prior surgery. This means have to take time to discuss with the patient, because some of them they will give up. All patients must have about their option, starting from glasses, contact lenses, and surgery. A good preoperative evaluation, a precise surgical techniques, and thorough postoperative follow-up and indispensable are indispensable for obtaining a high degree of patient satisfaction. Thank you very much from my team.